Welcome to the new version of D2L. In this video, we'll give you a preview of what's new in version 10.2. You'll see a new user interface that has streamlined navigation for you and for your students. We're pretty excited about the new design because it provides consistency for us without changing how you use the tools with which you're familiar. So this is your new My Home page. At the very top, this maroon bar is called your mini bar. The mini bar appears on every page in the system. You have your My Home button to return you to this page. Instead of My Courses, you now have Select a Course. Here's your list of courses. You're able to use the search box. You can sort courses by name or by the last access. You have a new feature called Pinning. These little push pin icons indicate that you have pinned a course. Once I pin a course, it stays at the top of my list no matter how I sort the list until I unpin it. You have notification icons at the top, and instead of the My Settings widget, you now have this drop-down menu under your name. You can access profile, notifications, account settings here, and students can check their progress. Under the mini bar, you have some personal navigation options and some system navigation options. Notice the system check button. That allows you and your students to check your personal technology against what's required for D2L. Now you'll notice your widgets look a little different now. News has been renamed News/Announcements for a little more intuitive naming. You now have My Task List, which allows you to create your own personal to-do list. You can use checkboxes with it, and you can set due dates. Here's your widget for important policies and people, and your calendar widget. Notice it's no longer a grid, it's now a list. And beneath that is your library help. So let's have a look at what a course looks like now. Come up to Select a Course and go to a class. The first thing you'll notice is that Select a Course has been replaced with your course name. This is now your course home button. So this is what you'll click to get back to the home page of your own course. You also can select other courses from here, which means you can move between courses from within courses instead of having to return to the My Home page. Your navigation bar has been streamlined, and this is to provide consistency and to help us with user tracking. Your news is News and Announcements, just like on the My Home page. And then beneath that is the important policies and people that students need to access. On the right is your calendar, which again is a list now, and these dates and times are automatically added whenever you create a due date. There's your update widget, and the content browser is now called Course Map. There's some neat features added here too. So let's get into the content. And as we move through the content, you'll see that they've added some features for you. You're actually able to edit the content from the course map. You can also navigate back and forth through the content in order using these navigation buttons. Each page also gives you a completion summary here. So as students access the content, you can see how they're accessing it, when, what their progress is. You can also set bookmarks. So if there's a page that you or your students return to frequently, you can bookmark that page and then just return to your bookmarks to find that page easily. Once activities have been added to the course map using the course builder. You can also edit them from the course map. So if I needed to edit this quiz, I could just click on quiz setup and be able to do that from here without returning to quizzes. So all the tools that you want to use are now under edit course. So instead of having separate buttons you have to go to, they're all located on one page. Here is your course builder for adding to the course map. Some neat features include in the Dropbox, you are now able to set a due date in addition to your end date. So you have your start date, your due date, and your end date. This allows you to accept late assignments past the due date before reaching a close date or an end date, after which you won't accept late assignments. Also in the Dropbox, when grading, you are able to save your grades as drafts and then release all of the drafts and feedback all at once instead of releasing them one at a time. Another nice feature is in discussions. You're now able to require your students to start their own thread or make their own post before they can read and reply to others. That way you know you're getting an original post and not one that's just based on what others have already posted. Another nice feature is in grades. In the inner grade screen, when a student has completed an activity, an icon appears. So you are able to click on that icon and immediately go to their submission. That means you can either grade it from here or answer questions about how it was graded. Now, before we close, I would like to emphasize that your course content now really needs to be added all to the course map. Students will no longer have the buttons up here to access content. You'll use the course builder to do this. You won't be able to change the navigation bar or the home pages any longer, so it's very important that all course content is linked in the course map. Now, don't forget to sign up for our demonstrations so that you get a little more detailed view of how to use these tools. Also, if you have any questions, please let us know.